You're finished. I'm putting you on a plane to Vegas. Tom? I want you to stay there. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
Only don't tell me you're innocent. Because it insults my intelligence. It makes me very angry. Now, who approached you? Tattaglia or Barzini?
It was Barzini.
Good. So if you're a fan of the original Godfather...
I still hold my breath during that. I know exactly what's going to happen.
Take the Uber, Carlo. Don't get in the car.
Don't do it.
You know what happens next. Gianni Russo played the classic role, and he is also the author of a tell-all memoir, Hollywood Godfather, the most authentic mafia book you'll ever read. Gianni Russo joins us in studio this morning. It's great to have you.
Yes. No, thank you.
People ask me all the time, what are my favorite movies of all time? Godfather 1 and 2 are in the top three. They're amazing movies.
Well, I appreciate that.
Yeah. So how did you even get involved with this movie?
Well, I always wanted to be an actor, and my ego was more than I could, better than my acting. And they had a problem with the unions. And I straightened it out. So with that said,
I straightened it out.
So I imagine everybody wanted to be in this movie. And so
yeah, I found that out later.
Did they have you give a screen test? You might have said, I want to try this.
Well, but I actually shot a screen test to play Michael, Sonny, and Carlo, because I had a few dollars. Mm-hmm. And I was at 25 at the time. And I submitted it, only to find out they were going to use real actors. And they were very nice about it. And then soon after that, they had a lot of problems with the unions and Joe Colombo, and they were picketing it. And I felt, let me straighten this out. Maybe I can get the part. So I did. And I got Joe Colombo and everybody. I brought him to the Gulf and Western building.
Yeah.
And we had a sit down. And then everybody agreed on everything. And I said, what about me?
Mm-hmm.
So Joe Colombo says, what about my boy? He's well going to give a part. I said, excuse me. I don't want a paw. I play Michael, Sonny, or Carlo.
I read too, speaking of acting, that Marlon Brando coached you with that. Is that right?
Yeah.
What kind of coach was Marlon Brando? I've heard so many stories about him. What was he
Marlon
like?
Marlon and I were really close from that day on when we met at a rehearsal. And he just realized he wasn't an actor, but he knew that I had to be great in this part. And so every day, I was in the makeup room with him and Dick Smith for 2 hours while he was becoming Don Corleone. And we'd go over my lines.
Yeah.
And he coached me.
Yeah, there are so many classic scenes that you're in the original Godfather, but the most classic scene, a little too graphic for us to show on television this morning, is when you get in the car with Clemenza. He's in the back seat and your character meets its demise. What was it like shooting that scene? It is maybe one of the most visceral, disturbing scenes ever on screen.
Well, first of all, you know, I knew I was going to die, so I had to really act that out. And then doing it like 13 times, going through a windshield, it's my first movie, I didn't realize, you know, the danger of it, because the back of my legs going through the glass, no matter what they did, because they wanted the authenticity of my legs going through the glass, I was all cut up. By the time I was done at the end of the day, I said, this is a tough business. And after Jimmy Caan breaking two ribs and chipping my elbow, now I'm all cut up. I said, I'm going to make love scenes from now on.
Let's talk about your growing up in your neighborhood. And you had a lot of run-ins with people in organized crime, right?
Well, they weren't run-ins. Basically, they were like family to me. Carlo Gambino, I saw him every day. O'Neill Della Croco. And then as I got into my teens, I met a guy called Frank Costello, and I stayed with him until he died, until 73. So I was not I never had a problem with the mob. Obviously, this I wouldn't be here. Mm-hmm. But no, they taught me a great deal of life in the way I had to. I mean,
walked away, though, at one point, didn't you? And then from the mob when you were young?
I really was never in the mob.
Okay, right.
But then I saw what was going on, and I had the opportunities, And I moved on and, you know, became very successful business-wise.
You have to read Gianni's book for one amazing story after another. But you're involved with some other things right now, including some food products that
Well, that's why I'm here now, in Chicago. Yeah. I fortunately were partners with Greco and Son after doing my research to get a distributor in the world. These guys are the best, and fortunately I did. And I bought the IP for all Don Corleone. I own Genco Olive Oil.
Get out of here.
Wow, well, good for you.
No, so I'm doing this for my grandchildren.
Yeah.
And fortunately, like today I'm here. I'll be at Tony's Fresh Market
in Niles. Right.
I'll be there from 3 to 7 tonight. Tomorrow I'm in Prospect Heights.
Yeah.
From 11 to 3. So if you're in town, come by, taste the sauce. I mean, you're going to think your grandmother made it. It's amazing. The olive oil, it's the original olive oil from Genco Olive Oil, from the Genco company, Barbera, in Sicily.
Wow.
And so it's been fun, and I'm doing it for my grandkids.
Yeah. When you go out to see Johnny, ask him about the Pablo Escobar story, who put a hit on him and then took the hit off when he found out that he was in his favorite movie, The Godfather. It's a long story, but it's in the book, and ask him about it.
Oh, then Sunday, I'm at that... out at the Rockford, Illinois.
Oh, yeah.
I'm doing Solo Italiano. I'll be singing there, signing books, sauce and all that. I'll be there all day.
That's great.
That's my whole weekend.
Gianni Russo,
enjoy
thank
yourself.
You so much for coming.
No, but thank you guys.
Honor really to meet you.
Next time we have a union problem, I'm going to call you, okay? <All right. laughs>
I watched you.
Nice to meet you.
We'll be back.